Hey everyone, we've got two updates. Yes, two updates for you today. HitFilm 15, I know you're all waiting for it, and a great update to Imerge, version 7. There's links about those down below, but do stick around to the end because we're going to be talking about all the money you guys have been raising with us for charity and also our new app, CamTrack AR. Let's start with HitFilm 15. A much requested feature is coming in this version, and that's auto stabilization. As it says, it stabilizes your footage and it does that all automatically, but then you can actually change the settings. So if it's cropping your frame a little bit too much, or if it's making some really unstable footage just a little bit too fluid and you want some of that movement in there, you can change the settings to achieve that. Next up, motion tracking. Have you ever wanted to stick something to someone's face, or maybe even have a word come up beside someone? That's what this tool's for. You can select the area. It's as easy as circling around a face or around an object, and then it will track that over time.
Whoa, this is heavy.
Next up, you've got color adjustment. You can use a color picker to select the color you want, like the skin tones or the green grass, and then you can increase or decrease the saturation and even move the hue around with a softness setting so you don't get any strange artifacts. Next up, we've got a crop and pan tool. So you can use this to create nice smooth animations, but maybe between two different points in a high resolution image or video, just by selecting where it begins and where it ends, and then it will go smoothly between them. And then we also have the crop effect. So you bring in a 25 megapixel image and you want to crop a certain area of it to be full frame. You can do that with this tool. Next up is a great tool for all you motion graphics artists, and that's mask shapes. So before, we've always had circles and squares and freehand, but what if you wanted the slightly rounded rectangle? Well, that wasn't possible. Neither were stars, triangles, or other polygons. They're all possible now in this update. And we also have settings on there, so you know, you can change the amount of sides, you can set how pointy the star is, all those kind of things. It's a really great tool. You're gonna love it. Another great tool for all you editors out there is the track select tool. We've had lots of requests for this. So yeah, if you want to select everything to the right of where you are or the left, you can do that easily with this tool. Furthermore, if you hold shift, it will only select the video or the audio depending on what you're clicking on. Another great tool for those into motion graphics is the ability to add multiple outlines onto your text. So you can create all sorts of amazing text with different levels and thicknesses of outlines, as many as you want, to create all sorts of different effects. As always, just to make things better, we've added a few more presets to some of the effects and also some more templates for your titles. So I hear you all asking, what is new in Imerge 7? Well, one thing that's new is HDR stacking. So this is your ability to create an amazing HDR image by going out and taking the same image at different exposures to reveal all of the details. Imerge will now put these back together from a stack into one perfect HDR image. As well as this, we have focus stacking. So if you were to go and take a photo at various depths of field, so you've got all these different blurry photos with just a small area in focus, it will put those together in a stack to create a really pin sharp photo. We've also added tone mapping, so it can take one of those HDR images and adjust it and keep that contrast, but so you can view it on a regular monitor. We've also added a bunch more preset stuff into the software, and one of the greatest ones is layer presets, which are like little utilities to help your workflow. So one of those might be import a green screen layer, and as you state it's a green screen layer, it's going to apply all the different effects that you need to get your green screening off to a great start. Even better, you can now import and export effects presets, so we really look forward to seeing what you guys create. You would think with two massive updates to our software, that would be the bit I'm most excited about, but actually it's the charity stuff that we've been doing. So we only started this in mid-January, and since then, with your help, we've raised $120,000 for different charities. This is going up all the time, and we are so grateful that you are going on this journey with us to try and help numerous good causes around the world. What more can I say? Thank you everyone, and thank you the FXhome team too. So, in case you didn't notice it last week, we released our first iOS app called CamTrack AR. What this allows you to do is, while you're recording your video, it tracks the camera at the same time in three dimensions for use inside your post-production software like HitFilm. You really should try it out. For a HitFilm user or a Blender user, everything you need is free, so go do that. So HitFilm 15 and Imerge 7 are out right now, and there's links in the description. Do go and try them out, download the demos, tell us what you think, and make sure to subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon, because we have lots of cool stuff coming later in the year. See you soon.